after a massive downpour and even hail, like hailstorm in Florida, we're going back to EPCOT. We were here earlier today, but it was simply too hot. And then it started to hail, rain ice. Yeah, let's have a little walk in EPCOT and see what we find today, or this evening. A lot of people are leaving the park, so my guess is that the fireworks are cancelled. And to be honest, I kind of arrived here for the fireworks, but we'll see. We'll have a walk. Maybe we go on some ride. Oh, look, he has a little snack. Oh, here is the security point. The fireworks don't seem to be cancelled, so I'm keeping my fingers crossed. So now I'm gonna go on Spaceship Earth. Not my favorite attraction, but it's an attraction. So that wasn't exactly a very thrilling attraction, but it will do. The thing where that takes your picture, it never works. A cell phone works better in the dark. Oh well, I got a little animation that I sent to my mail. Let's go in and have a look. I haven't exactly looked in this store yet because it's pretty new. I mean, it's not... Yeah. Pass holder. $45. It looks nice, but it says pass holder. So that kind of limits its audience. I'm not a pass holder. But yeah. This looks nice as well. And it doesn't say pass holder, but the problem is that I don't drink coffee. 45. Orange bird. $30. That's not bad, actually. Because it's an original orange bird. It's not just like a teddy bear or something. This looks amazing. Looks almost like in Japan. It's $40. Plus tax, of course. Munchling. How much is it? It has a secret price. Munchling, a secret price point. It doesn't smell like anything. How much is a munchling? It really doesn't say. That's annoying. Isn't it? How can they not write what a munchling is? Price that. Mini munchling. Secret price point. Ah, never mind. If they would have posted the price, I would have bought it. I would have bought it. I'm not just saying that. I would definitely have bought it. They're supposed to smell something, but I can't feel anything. Bags, and yeah, we have these bags. This is actually beautiful. I mean, I wouldn't buy it, but this looks good. That's design at a high level. Classic Disney. Here they have like a jewelry section. Don't know how much of it is actually jewelry, but you know. So how much is a Disney mug? We always make the videos of mugs in other places. It's $20. Really? $20? $20. I was just looking. One of these mugs, $20. With a lid, $25. These are nice. I like this design. This is really nice. $23. I really like that. Here's something that is not going into the washer. Is it 25? Washer. The dishwasher. Soap dispensers. How much are those? $8 plus tax. So I guess that is okay. And you can actually use a soap dispenser. A big super soft Mickey plush, Japan style. How much is it? It doesn't say. It has a mystery price point. It's $40. It's $40. Oh, look. I like this. This is really... I mean, you can have this as a statement piece at your home. It's $28. Looks great. Do you know the name? It's Oswald the Lucky Rabbit. Stitch in rainbow colors, something. This is monorail, radio controlled monorail. This is the most comfortable weather I've had in days. Feels fantastic. I just hope it won't rain again. There are some really dark clouds. At the time of filming, they have the topiaries. I filmed them from behind. Other people filmed them from the front. 100. So I guess the park celebrates 100 years. Who would have known that EPCOT would see 100 years in existence? That's pretty amazing. 100 years. Yeah. No, it's Disney's, the company. It's 100 years. Here we have the happy little dragon. Let's photobomb them. Let's go here. Take a look at that. Looks amazing. Oh, it's dripping from the monorail. Let's hope it doesn't fall down on us as we walk now. Flowers everywhere. Look at that. It's a huge Goofy. So one thing I have a problem with in this park. Oh, guy just dropped his popcorn bucket. That's a $45 wasted. Yeah, I never know where to watch the shows. There's so much space in the park, but I never know where to watch the show, the fireworks show. Is this the best place? I don't know. Here we have a little store. Disney Traders. Let's just have a quick look. $140 for a Black Panther mask. How much is this? It's actually wearable, but the price is hidden. It's $70. You can actually wear that, so it's usable. A little secret character. Surprise, $15. This is also nice. How much is this? Secret prize. Secret prize. $35. So this is kind of hideous, but let's check the price anyway. It's $70. I guess it's not hideous, but you know. Yeah, well. That's that. Let's move on. I didn't like the design of the store. So I felt kind of, I don't know, bored in there. Look, the donuts are about to sell out. So the question is, where is the best spot to watch the fireworks? When I've watched fireworks here in Epcot, I've always watched them from the same spot. And I think that was okay, but it's a different show now. It's, I think, Epcot Forever. And I've never watched that. I don't know anything about the show more than that it's like a celebration of the classic Epcot theme songs and, yeah, something like that. So here we have, like, pots and plants and, garden decorations. Not really my style. But, yeah. I think my garden deserves better. Three caballeros. I ate here earlier today. Ate the quesadilla and the taco vampiria, vampiro or something. Taco mac quack. And it was okay. It wasn't a huge success, but it was okay. I also had something at the citrus blossom over there. Oh, look at Spaceship Earth. I just have to point that out. Look that in the distance. That is nice. Oh yeah. Here they have a place called La Cantina. Ah, should have got something to eat there. And watch the fireworks show from there. I'm so bad at planning.
I will.
This building features a ride and a restaurant. But the ride is completely useless. It's like a boat ride. Oh my god. Listen to them.
And then we do it before we go to water. Yeah? Okay, are you okay if we bring Harry to do the Ratatouille ride tomorrow morning? We're all going to get up early and come here. Yeah? Meet you in the house, yeah? Do Ratatouille ride, yeah?
So they're from England and they're talking about doing the Ratatouille ride as if that was a big deal. Come on, you can do the Ratatouille ride in Disneyland Paris, it's only 2 hours away. Anyway, yeah. The Mexico Pavilion has a pretty bad attraction. It's a boat ride with some really dated looking dolls and yeah. Probably one of the worst attractions in Disney World. Why is this place empty? What? This is a fantastic spot. Why is it empty? Here we have the frozen area, Norway, but it's frozen. That's a dark ride, that is pretty good, a boat ride. So I found a bench, and I'm just gonna sit here and wait it out.
seems to be a living blueprint of the future.
Glowing majestically.